Hello everyone, Christina here. So glad to see you guys on this Saturday afternoon. Hello, a lot of you guys have been in the chat waiting for this live to start. Thank you so much for joining me. You guys are from all over the place. And I wanna say welcome to everyone watching this on the replay too, because you know I know you guys watch after the fact too, so thank you. Waiting for some comments to come through. Today, I'm going to be doing some mail art. I've been mostly in the yellow area of the rainbow for the last couple of weeks. I'm going to transition into kind of an orange shade, more of a coral. And so I thought I'd do this really pretty. I don't know if you guys can even appreciate the color of this envelope, because like next to the white, I don't know, it looks kind of yellowy on screen, but it's like this really pretty pale peach. It's from Paper Source, and this is the color Blush. You can see that up there. It's called Blush. It's so pretty. I'm just going to be using a pre-made envelope today because that just makes things easier. Hello, everyone. All right, so Amy Armington gave me permission to use her address. So this, I was doing a little preliminary, just figuring out how I want to do the lettering on the envelope. So when I actually do it on the envelope, I'm going to move the Amy over to be a little more center. And I'm going to make sure I write out this line before I do the descender on the G. That's going to make it so I don't have any weird overlap. So I'm going to zoom in here a little so you guys can see. And the lettering that I'm doing today is done with a Decobruh metallic marker from Karin or Karin. Not sure how to say it. And I really love these. They're beautiful colors. And it kind of has a, this is copper, but it kind of has a little bit of a brownish orangey shade, which I thought would go well with the colors of inks that I'm using today. We'll get into those in a minute. I'm gonna set those aside. And I'm gonna wait to do the stamping till I have my address on there too, because I want the stamping to kind of go around the address. So I kind of want to be strategic and plan this out well. Move some stuff out of the way. All right. Welcome to everyone who's here for the first time catching a live. I tried to be better this time. Usually it's very spur of the moment. I don't plan ahead too far. But yesterday I decided I wanted to do a live today. And usually that is not the case. It is, you know, like an hour before I go live. So this is fun. All right, so these pens, you do need to shake a little bit before you use them. So I'm gonna go in here and get going. I'm gonna use this as a reference up here so I can kind of see the direction I'm going. In fact, maybe I will do the Armington and then Amy up above. So here we go. And I love these markers. Like I said, I'm not going to do the descender till after I've done that first line of the address. Now this is pretty wet. I don't know if you guys can see this. I'm gonna put that up in the light. You can see how wet that is. So I'm gonna go ahead and work on the address down below and then go back to put her name up above, because I think that's probably the smarter thing to do. By the way, this address from Amy was given with permission. And as I do this address here, I'm trying to use lighter pressure on my marker because I'm writing so much smaller. Okay, I'm just gonna smooth out this area right here. All right, and then Englewood, Colorado. In fact, I've got quite a bit of space under here. So I think I'm going to spell out Colorado and then center the zip code down below. I think that would look really nice. The city and state aren't quite centered anymore, but that's okay. All right, and then I'll that's kind of at a weird angle here, but okay. A little bit messy there, but that's okay. I'm gonna go ahead and do this G and cross my T up here. Just do it like that. Get that a little thicker. Okay. And now I need to do Amy right up there. And I also need to be cognizant of the fact that I'm going to have postage up here. So maybe if I do have it a little off to the side, that'll be okay because the postage can fill this top area. The marker I'm using is from Karin or Karin. This is the Decobruh metallic marker. Okay, so this is mostly dry right here, but I'm going to take a little piece of paper and just rest it right there so it protects the lettering from my hand right above. And I think I'm going to do the Amy right here. Go. Strange little bump right there. I don't know if I'll be able to fix it. Meh, that was a good try. Okay. All right. So now I'm going to do, well, before I do the stamping, I want to pick my postage stamps because I want to make sure that the stamping isn't going to interfere with the postage stamps. So let's see here. I think I'm going to pick them out by color. And I'll zoom out here so you guys can see my stamp storage, postage stamp storage. I have to specify with you guys because I like to actually use regular stamps too, right? Okay, so this is, it's actually an album meant for stamp storage. And I'm gonna go right in here. I mostly want oranges almost into corals. And these are all vintage stamps that I've collected over the years. Many were sent to me by very generous viewers and subscribers. Other ones I've purchased online from different resellers. Okay, this color right here is kind of pretty. I think it would kind of go with what's going on over here. Ooh, or this one. I think that would look really pretty, really pretty too. Okay, so I'm just picking out some colors. Okay, there's this butterfly right here. It's actually 64 cents. I could just use this one and call it a day. But I do like to have a little extra postage, like some vintage stuff, because I think it just looks really neat. I really like this one right here. I could do this. And then the butterfly. But I think, you know, both of these have a white background. So I think I'm going to change it up. I want something that has a more solid background, so I'm not going to use that one. But I do like the butterfly. So I think I'm going to transition into yellows, which I don't necessarily want. So I'm going to go back. Okay, this is an interesting stamp. I have quite a few of these. Kind of an interesting mix of color. I think that could look really, really cool. All right, and then maybe something a little bit more brown. This one's nice. Joseph Priestley. I have no idea who that is, but he really matches my envelope. So I think maybe I'll put him in the corner. Put those right there. I think that's a pretty good mix. All right. just like that. All right. And in total, that's like what, 84, 94, 97 cents. This is so much postage. I'm not going to have an issue with this envelope being delivered. Okay. So, since I have my address on there, I am very much so committed to this envelope. So I'm going to go ahead and adhere the stamps. Hold on. I got to grab my water brush, which is across the room. There we go. Because I don't like to lick the back of these stamps, you know? The stamp book is available at Amazon. That's where I bought it. I wasn't planning on showing it today, otherwise I would have put a link down below. But watch for the replay. I'll have everything I've used today linked down below. All right, so I just use a water brush on the back of the stamp. And it tends to get it plenty sticky. Some people like to add a little bit of extra adhesive for the really older vintage postage, but yeah. Zooming in here so you guys can see what I'm doing. Okay, I think this one's actually a sticker. It is. Hold on, I have to text something. I have groceries that are on the port, so I've got to text and see if someone can grab them. Sorry to interrupt. Okay. All right, and then this last one. And I like to use the water brush, especially because I can tell how sticky the postage stamp is. Like that one got really sticky near the end. And I also have this water brush is also dedicated to postage stamps so that I'm not like getting it all gummy and then using it to like paint. Like that would be a little bit not so good. Okay, so here is my envelope. I'm gonna use some really simple stamping now. I'm using a really fun stamp set by Gina K Designs called A Happy Hello. Hello, everyone. So glad so many of you are here. Paola, I think that's how you say your name. She asks me a really interesting question. Would you consider yourself a stamp collector? No, not in the traditional sense. I am a stamp user. I guess I collect them to use them. So I'm more or less, I have a stash of stamps, I would say. But I guess I am a little bit of a collector because I can't stand to like, if I have multiples of the same stamp, I hate to use the last one. I want to keep one. So I guess in that way, I kind of am a collector. Joseph Priestley was a chemist and philosopher. Oh. Thank you. Vanessa just filled me in. Thank you so much. Well, now we know. He also matches my envelope. All right, so I'm going to mount these little flower stamps, mostly just these more compact like rose or dahlia or peony. I'm not sure exactly what they are. I want to use just those two. But then I'm going to take another block and I want to get the leaves on it. And I'm going to put the leaves... like I'll put these leaves in the corner of this block. I'm gonna turn it over and on the opposite side, I'm gonna put the single leaf. Yeah, I think those are the ones I'll be using today. So the colors of ink that I've got, these are all from Gina K. I've got Jelly Bean Green. This one is Peach Bellini. And this one is Tomato Soup. Ta-da. Okay, another question. How long does it take for you to learn how to write this well? I've been doing calligraphy since I was a teenager. So it's been like 20 years. It's been a long time. But it hasn't been like a steady study of lettering. Probably in the last few years, I've lettered a whole lot more than I ever have for the rest of the years of my life combined. So I don't know, just, you know, experience. It takes a long time. Okay, I'm gonna start with Peach Bellini. In fact, you know what? I think this one is not open. So I'm just going to cut that sticker so I can open it up. Jaden says, do you reuse postage stamps that come in on your mail, or you buy all your beautiful postage stamps? Well, technically you're not supposed to reuse your postage stamp. Usually they're canceled out and have a mark through them, so you can't anyway. Sometimes they arrive and there's not a mark through them, or maybe they've just missed it. Technically you shouldn't reuse it, but there are people who actually have stamp collections of used postage. They specifically collect postage stamps that have gone through the mail already. I buy all of mine unused so that I know that they're legit. All right, let's get to some stamping here. So I'm going to start with this Peach Bellini. Just inking up my stamp. Just put that little flower right there. Now this envelope has a little bit of texture on it. I'm hoping I get a good stamp. Oh, it's beautiful. I love it. Love. All right. I'm going to take the bigger one, do that one in tomato soup, which also... it's not open. So the butterfly looks like it was a 2010. If you're looking for the specific stamp, I just saw someone in the comments say they're going to look for that butterfly. The butterfly stamps are actually like a series. They come out quite a bit. Okay, so here's tomato soup. It's a little bit more of an intense red. That'd be nice to have kind of two shades working here. Have this one go off the bottom of the envelope. Ooh, that's gonna be really pretty. Now these inks tend to dry back just a little bit. So this is gonna be fun. Okay, I kind of want to try something. See if I can get two colors on the same stamp. This might, no, I'm not gonna do it. I was gonna try it, but I think it would probably have ruined it. And at this point, I'm in it, I'm dedicated, I'm using this envelope, so I have to be careful. All right, put another big one right there. I love that. Darker red, maybe I'll have this one really close. There we go. And I kind of just want like to get a few flowers up in here and onto the back of the envelope as well. Okay, going back to tomato soup. Actually, I probably should stamp a few leaves here. I'm going to. Taking the jelly bean green, because I know I'm gonna need some leaves in between these, and I wanna make sure there's space for them. Gorgeous. All right. These are really pretty stamps. By the way, this stamp set is from Gina K, and she had a new release this week. And go visit their site, go see their release. It's really awesome. They had a few little glitches in their shop right as it was going live, but I believe everything is up and running now. All right, gotta get this more, just the edge of that leaf. I love that. I'm not even using the single leaf. I don't know if I'll need it. I think I'll just take it off, because then my stamp can lay, or my block can lay flat. All right. Oh, that nestles in there just perfectly. Then I can do another of the lighter ink, the Peach Bellini, with a smaller flower. Put that right there. I love that. All right, I want to bring this up just to the flap. taking the darker ink on the smaller flower. And then I'm going to do the light ink on the larger flower. And I'm just going to have this come right here. I love that. All right, that looks like the perfect little spot for my leaves. Lovely. In fact, I'm going to ink up my leaves and fill in this little gap right here. Lovely. And I haven't had any flowers that have the same color side by side yet. And I think I kind of want to do that so it makes it look a little bit random. I'm going to do a small flower right there. Plus it's on the back flap, so it's a little bit over the side. Okay. And then I think I'll just do a couple things of leaves. Someone was asking about, they must have been asking about how they protect my artwork. I do use Tim Holtz Distress Microglaze quite a bit. However, everything I'm using today is waterproof, so I won't need to. Like, this marker is permanent. These inks are waterproof. And I wouldn't be putting the microglaze over the postage stamps anyway, so I don't think I need to even do microglaze on this one. So this is a really easy, simple one today. All right, I'm going to go ahead and put my green ink pad away, but I'm going to leave these other two open because just had a thought. I have a very small pencil here. I'm going to use the eraser of the pencil to do some dots. I think that could be kind of fun. So just like to fill in some areas. Isn't that cute? Just having a little dot, like a little berry type thing. So I'll just come over here and do a little dot. I think that's so cute. It fills in all the gaps. In fact, maybe I'll do two together. Oh, I think that's so cute. And then I want to switch inks. Just wipe on a baby wipe. I really love adding those dots. I think it's just so fun. Once again, the stamp set is Gina K, A Happy Hello. Go visit her shop. She's got some really cute stuff over there. All right. Trying to decide if I want any more dots. Or if I want to call it a day. I think I want to do a series of three right here. Just because there's like not a whole lot on that flap right now. It's just that right there. All right. I love how this is turning out. I wasn't entirely sure how it would work. Okay. Let's see. Make sure I'm putting the right lid on the right ink pad. All right, last thing to do is just add my address on the back. And even for this, I'm going to be using a waterproof ink. This is a Pilot Envelope Addressing Pen. And it is waterproof. So I'll just add my address on the back. This is my mailbox, actually, not my home address, by the way. And once again, big thank you to Amy for allowing me to use her address. Sorry for being silent for a minute here. Just need to concentrate. Okay. All right, there's the envelope for today. Super fun and fast. It's only been about 25 minutes. The pilot pen, it is over at simonsstamp.com. This is the extra fine. It's also available at jetpens.com. Those are two online shops that I have personally bought this pen from. All righty. The first marker that I used for her name, where did I put that? It is a Decobruh from Karin or Karine. It's a metallic brush pen. All right, any other questions? If it's if you don't have any questions, then I think I'm gonna close up shop and call it a day. This is just a quick little envelope for a Saturday afternoon. The postage stamp book that I showed you guys earlier is available over at Amazon. Look for like postage stamp storage album. You'll probably pop up. Lauren has a good question. Have you ever heard of anyone having problems putting the return address on the back? I've heard some people say that the post office accidentally scanned the back of the envelope. It has happened to me. Just like once or twice. And with all the envelopes that I send out, I think that's actually a pretty good record. But it has happened. If you are concerned about that and you want to make sure it absolutely arrives with no delay, no problems, go ahead and put it in the top corner. Okay. Connie asks about my blocks. These blocks that I use today are blocks that I got from Stampin' Up! About 5 million years ago. I still use them. They're fantastic. I like that they've got the comfort grip. I don't drop these. So I use them for their from Stampin' Up. Let's see. Why do you use multiple stamps? She's wondering about postage stamps. I could have, like I mentioned earlier, I could have just used the 64-cent stamp. I absolutely could have. However, I like to have the postage stamps be kind of like part of the envelope. So I tend to add on usually at least one or two extra stamps. Usually they're vintage. They don't have a huge value on them, like their face value. I just like to do that for aesthetic purposes. Amanda says, are you making a coordinating card? Probably not. For some of these kind of one-off envelopes, generally I'll just include a card I've already made. All right. Little Star asks, how can I improve my handwriting? Practice. It's all about practice. Get yourself a notebook. Maybe it could be a journal. And just start journaling and writing with a pen that you really love. Make it fun. Maybe write out some quotes, things like that. It's also kind of fun if you have kind of like you know where you want to go. So if you have someone's handwriting that you really, really love, you could sort of try to imitate their handwriting in your practice. That's another good way to just kind of improve your handwriting. All right, where do you get the vintage stamps? You can get them online at a bunch of different places. I like to order from Etsy. There's a lot of sellers there. Just look for unused vintage postage stamps. You can also get them on eBay. You can just Google it, and there's a lot of different sites. Shanda says that Simon is out of the pilot addressing pen. Try jetpens.com. I don't know if they're sold out of these, but they have a ton of pens. You will get sucked in there. It is like a rabbit hole. I'm just letting you know. Let's see. Da, 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 da. How are my cats? Shauna asks. They're doing great. They're currently napping on my bed. Wendy, I think that's how you say your name, has a suggestion for handwriting, proving handwriting. She says, look for online practice sheets. Some are free. It's a great suggestion. Highly recommend it. All right, we hit 30 minutes. So I think this has been a great live session. I hope you guys enjoyed today and had some of your questions answered. I'm sorry if I missed it in the chat. While I was working, it was a little bit hard to look over and see everything in the chat kind of scrolling by. But if you want to be included in my list of potential mail art addresses, the link's not going to be there now because I've got to like update the info box. But as soon as this is back online as a replay, look in the video description. I will have not only the supplies that I've used today, but I'll also have a link for how you can submit your address for mail art. So you'll see that. And it's actually a form that is shared for giveaways. So you can sign up and kind of submit your name to win giveaways as well. Which, by the way, all of you guys that are watching this live, you're going to get a heads up. I have something like 35 giveaway boxes ready to go with like supplies, leftover supplies, things I've used, gently used. They're pretty valuable. I'm just going to do a big, huge giveaway and send them to whoever's name is drawn. Fortunately, I think I'm going to have to limit it to US and Canada just because the postal service with international mail right now is a little bit sketchy with, you know, pandemics and all that. And it's, you know, mailing these packages is like upwards of $45 each when they're international. And I don't know if I can take on that cost. So I will be doing as much as I can for the giveaway though. So watch for that. I will be announcing it at Instagram first. I think I'm going to have it ready to go up Monday, but I'm going to announce it Instagram first. And it's going to be a one entry per person. We're going to make it even across the board. One entry per person. And no special consideration. You don't have to do anything special. You just enter your name and address and you're good to go. All right. I'm wrapping up, you guys. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you want to see more mail art, please go over to my Instagram. And I've got my mail art rainbow, or you can just go to hashtag mail art rainbow on Instagram and you'll see a bunch of my work. Thanks so much for joining me. I will see you guys in another video very soon.